from SkiTalk.com. We're here today to talk to you about the Headcore Ski Line. With me, we have Winx, one of our product testers from California Ski Company, and also Phil, my business partner. Phil, tell us a little bit about the changes in the Headcore skis.
Well, we're on the second generation of Headcores. First generation stormed the market in, I think it was around 2016, 2017, with the Core 93 becoming one of the reference skis in that low 90 millimeter category. Then the line expanded out. Now we're on the second generation of skis from Head. We've seen some running changes as far as shapes on the skis, sizing's a little bit different on some of the skis when we get into the bigger models, but we've also seen some construction changes on our second generation versions. So halfway through the, I guess the model run of this, what we would call it, we've seen a change coming in for 2023. And one of the things that we've seen is the addition of a new top skin on the ski, which actually added about 8% additional weight on the ski. But what it also brought to the ski was a lot quieter now, and all the cores now really, they've advanced to the point of being just a lot of feedback on the ski now to be a lot quieter on the snow. Winx, let's talk about the new skis in the whole collection and how the changes were made and some of the attributes of each ski.
Okay. Well, to start, we have the Headcore 87. The 87 is going to be a little more of your groomer specific ski. It's going to be, more even your East Coast ski. This is probably not one too many people gravitate to out west, but definitely is an option. You have a little less tip rise here than some of the others, therefore being a little grippier, a little quicker edge initiation. But overall, in terms of feeling, you start to see that a lot of them start to feel the same throughout the series in terms of universal flex.
Yeah. At 87 underfoot, the Core 87 really came in and had big shoes to fill because it replaced the Monster 88, which is a really popular ski amongst aggressive skiers out there on a hill. Dimensions on the 87 are 130, 87, 110, and that's in the reference 177. As we move up a little bit in size, going to the 184, we're going to find that width is also going to go up a little bit. As we go down in length, the ski is going to narrow a little bit. And what Head is really trying to do with this whole collection is they want the same experience. So whether somebody's skiing a 163 or a 184, that ski is going to be proportioned for that skier.
Absolutely. And then moving up, of course, we have the Headcore 93, which really has been the popular ski throughout the whole series. You know, so I can see a lot of people going towards this. Maybe not quite as wide as the full West Coast ski, but something that can balance in between, you know, maybe something that, again, could be used as a travel ski. Again, what they're doing with the carbon, the Karuba, and the graphene is really consistent throughout the line. You do get a little more tip shape, so you're going to get a little more flotation out of this ski when you take it off piece. But overall, still sort of geared for, you know, more the on-piece, go-everywhere West Coaster.
Yeah. At 93 underfoot, with the Core 93, I would have to say that ski, probably the sales of that ski are going to be about what all the other skis are combined. Dimensions on that ski are 133, 93, 115, also in that reference 177.
Yeah. Moving up in the line, of course, we have the 99, which gained a lot of popularity the second year the Core came out.
Yep.
And that's just because of maximum versatility. We have a lot of skis in that range, and I think Head wanted to compete a little more.
Yeah.
So the 99 always felt like a little stronger than the 93. Maybe start to take that more as like your tree ski, your couple inches of fresh snow day. Once again, we don't start to see too much of more shape coming from the ski, more or less just a wider platform.
Right. Now, and with the dimensions of the 99 being 134, 99, 120, and you see these increments are going up in minute increments in the tip and tail because the direction of the skis are actually changing a little bit to open up that ski and to feel a little bit on the snow. Now, personally, I was not a huge fan of the first generation 99. Never really, for me, did a lot of things well. And it gets into, there's no bad skis or wrong skis. For me, it was a wrong ski. It just didn't work. No big deal. But this new one, I really felt much more at home with this new ski. I think the tip shape on it in this new generation was a big difference for it. I think it was definitely a ski for me moving in the right direction.
Absolutely. And I thought the 99 felt incredible compared to the previous generation that I skied.
First of all, it was kind of planky in the ski.
A little bit. Yeah, it didn't have as smooth a flex.
Yeah, no, I agree with you there.
Next, we have the 105, which actually, for me, becomes a really versatile ski. We've seen the 105 category really start to expand over the last few years. The original Headcore 105 was used a lot as a touring ski, mm-hmm. Or you know, a hybrid setup. Yeah. Maybe they're throwing a hybrid binding on it. So that's what I'm still kind of really excited about, the 105. Not that you couldn't use it as your lightweight powder ski, but the next ski we're going to be talking about sort of fills that gap a little more. But the 105, great sort of everyday. Maybe, you know, if you're traveling around the Pacific Northwest, could be a great option if you're not sure what the conditions you're going to get.
Yep. And again, we're seeing these dimensions going up 87, 93, 99, 105, going up a couple of millimeter increments as we go up. But again, we're noticing that the tip is only going up 130, 133, 134, 135. So again, the shape of these skis is where we're seeing some change on them, because as that ski gets wider, you don't want that ski to have a nervousness to it. Now, you'd pointed out that as far as the original was used a lot for touring, okay? With the new generation of skis, with adding a couple of 8% as far as weight on the ski, we're losing some of that touring capability out of it. But Head is also offering the Core X collection, which is a lighter weight version of these skis. So for people that are looking for these skis and are happy with the shape of the skis and the way they ski, they want to tour something, that's where their Tour X collection is coming in.
Right.
Now, as we move up to the one, cross over that 100 millimeter segment, is when we also see the ski start to change a little bit in shape. We're seeing a little more rise here in the tail as compared to the sub 100 millimeter wide skis. So we're seeing that change here. So we're seeing obviously a little more off-piste ability, and we want a ski that actually is going to work its way out of a turn really nice and easy. And having that little bit of rise in the tail once we get over 100 is making a difference.
Right. Lastly here, we have the 111. The only one not featured currently is the 117, yep. Which is really for your big, deep days.
Yeah.
I think the 111 serves a really nice purpose. That's when you get a lot more tip shape.
Yeah.
I mean, you're really getting into a true powder ski on this one. It could be a really good tree ski as well, but maybe a little overkill. But as Phil was just saying, with the added tail rise as well, it starts to become a little more free ride. A little more playful, maybe a little more smeary.
Yep.
Definitely, I would probably start to reserve that as your like 1 foot dump days.
Yeah.
That we don't get too much out here in the West, but maybe in Utah, that could be a great ski.
Yeah. And you can see as far as the shapes of the tips, these through here is very similar as far as the shape, but we see a lot more taper as this tip rises up through here. So our contact point is back here with much more tip, and as you said, much more powder oriented, that tip is not going to get pulled around in that really deeper snow.
Right.
So where here, it's definitely that more of a traditional shape in the tip. So that's going to be more of your, as you progress this way, a little more hard snow, definitely here, a little bit soft snow. And again, imagine here that 117, which is a bigger version, big brother of this guy over here. So this is, again, the Head Core Collection for men for 2023.
Now we're talking about the women's side of the Core line. And because Winx and I tend to ski a lot of skis in the same size because we're similar in weight, we have a lot of general references that are similar to each other. One of the things that I really like about what Head did with the Core series for women this year is they changed how they name the ski. For an example, one of the most popular skis was the Headcore 93, and a woman would come into a shop or they would talk to us online and ask for the Core 93, but the reference size, the longest size for women, was actually 91 millimeters underfoot. So we didn't really have a real Core 93. Now that reference size in a 170 is the Core 91, so it more accurately describes what that particular lineup of skis is. As we talked about earlier, they made the ski more damp. The women's version has a different wood core. It's the Aruba wood core, but it has made the ski stronger, in my opinion, and a little more damp, a little more confidence inspiring.
Yeah, I would say so. With the women's in the 85, that really brings on, you know, that groomer specific ski that a lot of women have been looking for over the years. I mean, at 127 tip, 85 in the waist and 108 in the tail. I mean, that's just such a great shape.
It's the cream of the crop. And honestly, that's probably one of the most coveted spots on the women's side of the wall. Anything between 85 and 88 on the women's side of the wall is what 80% of the women are asking for if they're experienced skiers walking into a shop.
Absolutely. I like that we have something like the Core 91 to start to bring women into those 90s. We just don't see a lot of that happening. And I don't know if that was like an industry thing or a ski shop thing, but it's almost like we told women, like, don't go above 90. And I mean, surprisingly, there's a lot of good skis in that category.
Absolutely, there are. And one of the things that I like about that particular category is the 91 falls into that sweet spot. So if you're going on a vacation, you're not quite sure what the weather's going to be like, and you want a ski that's going to be okay on groomers, but it's going to slay in moguls, and if you have a little bit of powder, it's going to handle it just fine. The 91 is a great size for the average woman, depending on how big she is and how strong of a skier she is. But then we step up to the 97, and the 97 is getting into a little bit more of the big mountain free ride zone for most women, and that's something where you're gonna have to be a little bit stronger skier to jump on that, I would dare say.
Yeah, I mean, even though we still see like the same materials made throughout the skis, certainly as you go wider, it does stiffen a ski a little bit because you have more surface area to push on.
Correct. And you have a little bit more to engage to try to get it to come around.
Yeah.
So that's just a natural inherent value. One of the things that I found interesting, and maybe you can grab that 103 over there on that end. So the 103, I would use something in that width as a powder ski. And one of the things that is really nice is if you look, you can tell the tail shape. There's more rocker in that 105 than there is in the 97. So it's gonna release a little bit better. It's gonna give you a little bit more of that surfy, floaty feel when you get into that deeper day. So I would say that's a out west ski, maybe a Canada ski for a woman, something like that.
Could be. I mean, even though they have increased the weight a little bit, I always like to touch on the fact that these skis used to be all around skis. They used to be good at hybrid skis, mm-hmm. partial touring skis, and even though they increase the weight, I wouldn't be afraid to throw some of these hybrid bindings on it and use it as a travel ski.
Yeah, absolutely. It's definitely in that particular spot for me. Thank you for joining us today while talking about the Headcore skis. Thank you, Winx, for joining us, and
absolutely.
Don't forget,
skiing is fun
always.
If you enjoyed this informative video, hit that bell, subscribe so that you'll stay up to date on the new videos, and check out skitalk.com for more ski-related content.
Also, please follow skitalk.com on all of your social media channels. No scenes from Hot Dog the Movie were quoted during the production of this video.